Привіт-привіт! Welcome to my YouTube channel Ukrainian with Inna. And today we're going to study top Western Ukrainian dialect words that are commonly used in Lviv. So, поїхали, let's get it started. So you can ask me, Inna, what is the dialect? The dialect is the common territorial, professional or social variant of a standard literary language. So, in Ukraine, there are three major dialectical groups according to the territory. So, we have the southern western, the southern eastern and northern groups of dialect. And of course, we are going to study today one of the most popular one, the western, among the western dialects is the Halytsky dialect. Halytsky dialect is a dialect that is used in Lviv. And I'm sure that you have heard some of these words many times in Lviv restaurants, cafe, how the Ukrainians speak there. And it's very interesting. And I'm sure it's going to be very, very useful for you. So let's start this vocabulary right now. So the first word that I'm going to teach you is балакати. Балакати, also people say базікати, базікати. Балакати or базікати is a dialect word that means говорити, говорити, to speak, говорити. For example, I would like to offer you to make examples with me because it's a very good practice to study the vocabulary by using them in a context. Моя подруга любить багато балакати. Моя подруга любить багато балакати. My female friend likes to speak a lot. Моя подруга любить багато балакати or базікати. The next word is баняк. Баняк. Баняк, it means каструля. The standard Ukrainian variant is каструля. It means a bowl for cooking some food there. Наприклад, моя мама зварила великий баняк борщу. Моя мама зварила великий баняк борщу. My mom has cooked a big bowl of borscht. The next word is біня. Біня means дівчина. Біня – дівчина. So, дівчина, the English translation is a girl. Наприклад, яка гарна біня. What a beautiful girl. Яка гарна біня. What a beautiful girl. Also, I tell the truth, I haven't heard this dialect word a lot in the Western Ukraine. I heard another dialect word like kobita, that also means a girl. So biña or kobita, these are two dialect words that means a girl. Або яка гарна кобіта, what a beautiful girl, the same. The next word is виходок. Виходок. So when the next time you're going to Lviv, pay attention that you can see in the restaurants or in cafe a door with a table on it. Виходок. Виходок, it means туалет. Туалет, a toilet. Виходок, туалет, a toilet. So, наприклад, let's make an example. Біля виходку зібралася велика черга. Біля виходку зібралася велика черга. There is a big line near the toilet. Біля виходку зібралася велика черга. The word коліжанка. Коліжанка means подруга. Подруга, коліжанка. English translation is female friend. For example, ми з коліжанкою збираємося до театру. Ми з коліжанкою збираємося до театру. Ми з my friend are going to the theater. Ми з колежанкою збираємося до театру. The next Western Ukrainian dialect that we are going to study is Brama. Brama means ворота. Brama, ворота, and the English translation is the gateway. So, an example. Багато років тому величезна брама захищала Львів від нападників. Багато років тому величезна брама захищала Львів від нападників. Long time ago, a huge gateway protected Lviv from the attackers. The next word that we're going to study is Vuyko. Vuyko means дядько. Vuyko, дядько, and the English translation is uncle. Наприклад, мого вуйка звати Тарас. Мого вуйка звати Тарас. My uncle's name is Тарас. And вуйко, uncle, and вуйна. Вуйна, the standard version of this word in Ukrainian is тітка, вуйна, тітка, and aunt. Aunt, мою вуйну звати Олена. Мою вуйну звати Олена. My aunt's name is Олена. So, вуйко та вуйна. Uncle and aunt. The next word means зупа. Зупа or soup or soup. Так, so зупа. In every Lviv menu, you can see this word. So pay attention next time. Зупа. Soup. Коли хворієш, обов'язково треба їсти гарячу зупу. Коли хворієш, обов'язково треба їсти гарячу зупу. When you are ill, you should eat hot soup. Гречний. Гречний means вічливий. Гречний, вічливий. The English translation is polite. For example, будь ласка, будьте вічливими один з одним. Будь ласка, будьте вічливими один з одним. Please be polite with each other. The next two dialects were very connected to each other. So, the first one is гуляти. Гуляти. Actually, I use this word in my daily speech as a slang, and it means to play or to go out. But in Western Ukraine, as a dialect word, it means to dance. Танцювати. Гуляти, танцювати. And the word забава. Забава, it means свято. Забава means свято. The English translation is holiday or celebration. So, for example, на забаві люди полюбляють добре погуляти. На забаві люди полюбляють добре погуляти. On the holiday, people like dancing a lot. Ось так. So, погуляти and забава. These two words can be connected with each other. So, наступне, the next dialect word is зимно. Зимно means холодно. And you can remember this word very easy because зимно is an adverb that comes from the word зима. And зима is a noun that means winter. So, зима, зимно, холодно means cold. An example. Взимку в Україні завжди дуже зимна погода. Взимку в Україні завжди дуже зимна погода. In winter in Ukraine it's very cold weather. Взимку в Україні дуже зимна погода. The next Again, food dialect word is kanapka. Kanapka means бутерброд. So pay attention, in the Lviv menu you can see, when you open the menu you can see a title, kanapki. Kanapki, it means like appetizers. Kanapki. Бутерброды is like very small appetizers. Kanapki. And the last Western Ukrainian dialect word that we are going to study today is knaipa. Knaipa means bar, ресторан, забегаловка. And the English translation is pub, bar. And this is a place where people usually drink alcohol drinks. Так, наприклад, у львівській кнайпі є багато смачних домашніх наливок. У львівській кнайпі є багато смачних домашніх наливок. In Lviv bar there are many tasty homemade liquors. Ось так. So that's it. So, I hope this video lesson was very useful for you. Please tell me if you would like to study more Western Ukrainian dialect words from Lviv, because it will be very useful for you to know them, because everywhere in Lviv you can hear, you can read, and you can see these dialects. So, it's very interesting to know them very well. So, I hope you really enjoy it, and please support my YouTube channel. And I will be happy to teach you more and more the Ukrainian language. So, see you soon. Побачимо скоро. Па-па.